If you have started to reflect on 2019, I'm sure you're thinking 2020 will be the best year ever. And it really feels that way, right? It's a whole new decade and literally a blank sheet of paper. And I truly, truly feel that we are totally in control of making it the best year ever. If you're prepared to do the work, of course, and if you are continuously, putting in that work and being consistent, because that's where we all fall down, right? We have all these goals, New Year's resolutions, and then February comes along and it's like, oh my gosh, I completely lost it. So we don't want that, right? So also, I guess for some of us, we need to make a decision. How do we want 2020 to look like? Perhaps you are still in a job which you don't like, so it may feel like there's a bit of a decision and perhaps a leap, perhaps a risk to take to actually make that next move and decide to perhaps start your own business or change your career. And if you are running a business, then you might want to think, okay, where do I want to be in business at the end of 2020? How do I want my business to look like? Not only from a financial perspective, but also from a feel perspective, from like a team perspective, or who do you want to serve? So there's many, many different questions. But one of the real important steps is for me, before I get to kind of the future point and how is it going to look like in my business, what I'm going to do every day in my business, I'm actually looking at the learnings from last year. So let me just help you understand your learnings. Perhaps if you have a pen and paper, you might just want to ask yourself a few questions. So firstly, ask yourself, what did I do well? Obviously, we want to recognize what you've done really well, which areas you've excelled in, what were the things that really excited you. And maybe it's those are the things you want to do more and you want to continue doing more things in 2020. So what particular task, if you do have a business, what particular task in your business did you excel on? So what really worked and what felt easy? Because obviously we don't want to be working hard in our businesses. We want to create success, and of course with that success also financial rewards as best and as easiest possible, right? So which areas may those be? Which areas may you want to expand on? And then I look at the other side, which are the areas that didn't work very well. So what are the things that in your business that you really didn't enjoy doing? So maybe it's time to do it differently, or maybe to get someone on board to help you with that. Perhaps you had, you launched a product or a service which may have not gone so well. There's always a learning behind that. So don't, you know, take it as a failure. Take it as like, okay, what can I learn from this launch? What are the things that may have not gone so well? What could I do better and different in the future? Okay, so it's really important that you see that as a positive way to actually implement that in your business going forward, that sort of knowledge, because it's an experience. And we're all growing every single day. Even if we have bad experiences, it's still a growth experience. And lastly, just write down, how do you feel about 2019? What emotions do you have right now? Okay, so just write it all down. So we're kind of looking backwards. And join me in the next video when I'm going to talk about how we can now look forwards and then help you plan for 2020. I see you then.